So yeah, playing against Cardiff, they're always a very skilled team. Their top two lines especially have a ton of skill, and we know that. And they're a deep team, four lines deep, 6D. They play a good solid team game, and we know coming into those they're going to be tough games always. They're always going to push us to our max, so we know that we have to play to our best of our ability at every minute, and you can't let off.
Things up at 2 with 12:59 left in the second. Dundee 2, Cardiff 2. Chasing this one down. And down low. Round it comes again. Mosey wheels this one round. Oh, a chance in front. Oh, a goal! I think it's given. Yes, it is. Kevin Carr protesting, but it did go behind him. Oh, we'll put that back into the corner. Also, Richardson, he will send that one round. Oh, that's kept in the score. Somehow, oh, that's a goal, surely. Oh, no goal there. Devils have got a chance on the empty net goal here. Yeah, they do. It's known with Toby Craig in the centre. But it won't matter. Devils with the empty net goal with 104. Well, final score this evening then. Mad scenes at the end of this one. Brian Dow still raging at the referee.
And I think that was one little issue for us in this game. We had a little hiccup where we took a couple minutes off and they capitalized on those. And it really was our opportunity and our fight back that was a big thing against Cardiff in this game. We never quit. We gave ourselves a chance right at the end. And putting those goals together late, or the goal together late to get us back into the game and then give us a chance to pull the goalie late in the game. Yeah, it was key, and it showed our resiliency, and it was too bad we weren't able to get the 2 points from that game, but yeah, we definitely took a lot from that and hopefully take it to the next game. The Teddy Bear Toss, it's a great event for us at this time of the year. Obviously, around Christmas, it's a very important event for us to give back to the community And I know it means a lot to the players, especially like everyone's all excited and they're wanting to score that Teddy Bear goal, because that's just something you can always tell your kids about later on, or tell your family about, that you had the opportunity to score a Teddy Bear toss and make all the Teddy sail onto the ice. But no, it's an exciting event, and it's obviously always good to get back to the community and go to those hospitals and meet some of the people that are going through a tough time. And just being able to give back to them and see their faces light up at Christmas time, it's an amazing feeling.
Allen. Back to Rinaldi. Chipped in front and it's there. The shot was looking go wide, but a stick dangled out in front and tipped its way past Wall. And first blood to the Dundee Stars, 1-0.
We felt like we played well enough that we had a chance in that game, but it was important that we came back and didn't let off the gas. And obviously, it's another game where we had a little letdown where they scored 3 goals in 2 minutes or something. And we put ourselves behind the pedal a bit.
Is in on goal, in on car. Goal! Here come the Bears. One-timer off the bar, goal! The power play finally executes to the Cardiff Devils. Justin Crandall pops the rebound away. And the Devils getting right back at it. Another chance coming in, yes, save, goal! Jugger from Carr, who's going to play it. Chance and goal! Bush. Has it blocked, Rimshaw, goal!
Again, we never took our foot off the gas, and that's one thing I'll say about these two games is that we were resilient to the end and gave ourselves a chance at the end, and those 3 goals late to make it a 1-goal game really gave us a chance.
Dow! Goal from Dryden Dow, a blast from the blue line. And Devils here throwing a pack and a goal! 5-3. And it's creeping into a grandstand finish here at the Vindico Arena. That was a snipe. Puts it out in front. That is close. Another save, Wall, it's falling through. And well, his gloves off in the crease.
And we have a game with 2:12 to go.
Start in front for Rinaldi. Off the bar. You will not get closer than that without scoring. The Devils just happy to punch that out. We're going to the 5-4-3-2-1. The Devils do enough.
And you know, you can credit the resiliency, but it's very important that we don't let ourselves get into those stretches where we put ourselves behind, because it's too hard against teams like that to come all the way back. So Sheffield, they're always a strong team. You always expect a lot from them, and this year especially, they've been doing very well. They've put together a bunch of wins in the league, and they're climbing up the standings. So we know going into that game that it's going to be a very tough game, but it's very important for us to not get in the mindset that they're like too much for us. Like, we definitely need to make sure that we can play with them, and we know we have the ability to play with any team in this league. Like, there's nobody in this league that we feel is too good for us or that we can't contend with, but we know, especially against teams like Sheffield, that we're gonna have to play at the best of our abilities to even have a chance.
And these Steelers will break this away.
quick move up the ice. Newman breaks on into the centre, scores! What a finish! Newman sticks the brakes on, top of the circle, pass into the centre.
Takes a shot and it is in the back of the net. Sheffield Steelers take a 2-goal lead.
It's Dowd in the corner. Don't know how it got there. Tipped in! What a goal from Ciampini! Tipped in superbly. Carr with no chance on that whatsoever. Mistake in the zone here. Chance for Sheffield for number four, and it's Robert Dowd. What a goal for number four on the evening. Dowd still going down. Tries on another one. Goal, it's gone in! Robert Dowd with his second goal of the evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sheffield Steelers.
Well, we definitely got exposed by the best team in the league tonight. We had some good spurts there in the game. First period was kind of close. You know, we had a terrible dive in on their first goal that exposed us there in the back. And it was in the back of our net. That kind of changed the course of the game right there. But, you know, right now we just don't have that killer mentality. I don't care who we're playing, Cardiff and Sheffield. Yeah, we played them five of our last six games, but that doesn't matter. You have to have killer instinct every night and winning mentality when you come to the rink every night ready to play.
Yeah, it's a good rivalry we have with Glasgow, and going into their building is always fun. Having them here is always a good crowd, and you know, they're a good team and we're also a good team, so I think the matchup is pretty good and hopefully we can sweep them the rest of the year.
Championship mentality. All right, boys, here we go. Brent, here we go. All right, boys, carrying that read over from last week. We got H.
Hey.
We got V.
Hey.
We got N.
Hey.
We got P.
Hey.
We got D.
Hey.
And we got C in it. Yeah.
Thank you.
Happy holidays.
Hey,
yeah!
You going out to Glen Rothes?
Aye!
Glen Rothes!
Wow! Who's this? Jerseys?
Chelsea Bond!
Listening.
Hey, are you guys listening to me?
Yeah.
What? Get in here, Jimmy! Get in your Ingles!
What?
You're losing
Teacher
us,
H. You're losing Professor us. H.
Speak louder!
You're losing us, H. Alright, boys, big W. Back on the right track. I'm gonna give this one. He had limited service out there, but he tucked on Brenton.
So obviously the confidence was pretty high coming off that Glasgow game, and it was nice to have a little bit of time to celebrate the holidays and Christmas, but we knew it was important for us to get right back at it and not get into a lull after the holiday break. It's pretty easy sometimes to just take the foot off the pedal for a little bit, but obviously we wanted to have a big response, and we knew how important it was for us to get points in these games, especially against Glasgow and Fife. They're two teams that are right around us in the standings, so we knew how important it was just to gain some separation, and especially against your Scottish rivals, you always want to win those games. So yeah, it was definitely a big game for us to come out and play to the best of our ability.
Nothing to it but to do it here. I'm from. We got H.
Hey.
We got B.
Hey.
We got F.
Hey.
We got P.
Hey.
We got D.
Hey.
And a big C in that.
Hey.
Oh.
You'll be enjoying it some more.
Yeah.
It was a good game for us. Obviously, got the win out of it. Definitely, probably not the game that we initially expected going into it. Obviously, we thought we would come out flying more, but you know, it took a little bit of time to get into the game, and then once we got our legs going, I felt like we kind of took over the game as the game went on. So it was definitely good to get our feet back under us, and even when you're not playing your best, to get those 2 points, that's like the important part, so we'll definitely take that win.
This could go to a lot of guys. That was a hard-fought win. By the way, we stayed composed. We came out with the 2 points. But I'm going to give this to Dallas. He's eating up minutes and
just yeah. What's up?
Alright, boys, good win tonight. Two's a fluke, three's a streak. So that's good.
Woo! 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 Woo!
The line, fires one, oh it's gone in! Johnson for the starts, accelerates across the line, still going Johnson, driving in close with this one. Oh, Johnson scores a tremendous goal for the Stars. Johnson in down low for Rinaldi, Rinaldi trying on the backhand, it's in close, oh it's across the line! Absolute persistence from the Stars. Chance here for Britain, here's McKay, McKay fires, oh it's loose and it's across the line! Number five, is it? Johnson pops this out, in the blue paint it is. Oh, it's jammed through the legs. And Rinaldi scores number six for the Stars. Valentini turns and fires, it's tipped home. What a piece of work that is from Valentini. It's in the neutral zone. Oh, Rinaldi giving chase, going to reach it as well, Rinaldi. Rinaldi in close, what a goal for the Stars. Johnson pass to Rinaldi is good. Rinaldi across the line, accelerates in close, shoots and scores! Rinaldi with the hat trick, and it's goal number nine for the Stars with 18:26 left in this game. Anthony Rinaldi, three goals. Stars are legs in the zone here, moving at pace. It's Valentini down the left hand side, still going Valentini, drives one in, shoots and scores, and that is number 10 for the Stars. And Valentini with his first goal of the game. Enough to take the sting off it. Flares into the zone though. Giodo fires one, scores! Consolation has been scored from the Fife Flyers. Yes, that's going to be that though.
So a 10-1 win, obviously, that's a huge win for our team. Yeah, we're very excited. It's nice always getting a win like that. But the big thing for us was definitely that you can't get ahead of yourself. Like, you're not going to have many games like that in this league. Every game is usually very close. So we knew we had to stay grounded, especially going into our next game against Belfast, who we knew it was going to be a tough challenge. So.
10-1, the trademark, Dundee scores! Sorry, one assist and three goals! Sponsored by University of Dundee, number 17, Anthony Rinaldi!
Tonight, obviously. obviously. A lot of guys stepped up tonight. Charzy, great game again. But this guy was absolutely dynamic tonight, so Siege. Oh! Yeah!
I think all the guys know that Belfast is a really tough place to play. Not only are they a great team, but they tend to pack that arena and they play really well at home. The travel is always tough for us getting there. We had to take the ferry that day. Waves were really rough. We had a guy get sick on the ferry, actually. And so you have to kind of put all that aside and get ready to play. And I thought we did a good job of that. We actually played a pretty good game, and I think we maybe deserved a little bit better than what we got. Ended up being a 3-0 result, but I think we all knew that we had played well enough to at least get a point, maybe two out of it, and it just didn't work out in our favor. So I think we took that momentum into the next day because it was a quick turnaround, and we felt like if we can continue the way we played from the night before, that maybe it could go our way.
As we talked about it earlier, a heavy line, hard to deal with. They come up with these opportunities.
Phelps from distance is in! It's hit the body in front! Davey Phelps with a shot! A little drop off for Quinn Preston back to Curley. Curley has options. The outside looking for a back chance there. Shot. Oh my word! What a save by Kevin Carr!
Simon,
absolutely sensational.
Let's close the save of the week competition now.
Good stick in the lane by Greg Prince. Prince now. Prince driving forward, cuts to the middle. Greg Prince! Oh, his own work! We thought he got a goal earlier in the game. He gets one now. It's 2-0 Belfast. Valentini plonks himself just to the side of Jackson Whistle's net. Belfast clear. Now they have a chance to drive down the left side. A shot from distance, and it's all over. McIntyre makes it 3-0. I shouldn't have said it's all over just yet.
Yeah, the Hogmanay game was a special one. I think we could all feel the energy in the building. It was a packed house. The crowd was loud.
Hey, but let's go! What's the price for the game tonight? Oh, I know, bro, we got Rhino! Hey! Johnson! Hey! Bookland! Hey! Jimmy's in the back! Hey! Milo's in the back! Hey! Marcy's fucking kicking 49ers! Hey! 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 Hey!
Across the line, and that is very, very fortunate for Belfast. Flicks it back out to the line for down. 55 seconds left. Baldwin pushes this one through, fires and scores, and Spencer Nass throws a goal back for the Stars on the power play with 10:19 left in this game, and this building erupts. Cross-ice pass, flicked in, chance, score! Spencer Nass busts the back of the net with that one. 47 seconds left in this game, and the Stars tie it up at 2. goals apiece, and Spencer Nass with his second goal of the evening and his 16th of the season. Johnson from the start then, close behind the shot of the shooter. Johnson in close with the handling. Oh, that's a brilliant finish from Johnson. Superb, an advantage. Ben Blake then from the Giants takes this in down the centre, moving quite slowly. Accelerates in down the middle, puts the brakes on, shoots, pass across the line, he sneaked it in. Whistle initially made the stop, and just Swiftfield underneath him. Here he comes, moving at pace, gets on the eyes and misses. Valentini will kick this over from the left hand side. End up moving in, shoots and scores! Now the Stars in the shootout. That's the score. Here he comes. McLeod in close, denied by Carr. And a win for the Stars on penalty shots over the Belfast Giants on Hogmanay in Dundee, and 2 o'clock face-offs should definitely happen more often.
Coach a lot of credit. We practice shootouts quite a bit, and you know, if you look at our record in shootouts this year, it's been pretty good, and I don't think it's any coincidence that we practice it. And that game against Belfast was another example. Carter started us off, and that's a big you know, a big spot to be in to get the shootout off on the right foot, and he scored a big goal there. I was able to add one, and then Ryan with a beautiful shot into the top corner to make us 3-for-3, and Kevin shuts the door like he normally does, and that gave us the nice win. So yeah, whenever you can go 3-for-3 in a shootout and have the goalie make all three saves as well, that's as good as you can do.
Shut the door, but I gotta give it to number 8, Spencer Nass!
Spencer Nass! Spencer Nass! Spencer Nass! Spencer
Nass! That's gutsy as f***, boys. We laugh about the travel and everything, but for us to, you know, rally together and get that done is huge. I think we can see what we do as a team when we play the way we can. Like, we can beat anyone in this league, so let's keep it going, boys. And
yeah, so that Hogmanay result, that was a big win for us, obviously.
just the resilience of the team in that game, going down 2-0 and then being able to fight back in that third period and get those two goals from Nosser. Obviously, he really stepped up in that moment and carried us on his back for that. Yeah, just getting that result and having that resiliency as a team, that never quit attitude. Like, going into that third period, we always thought we were still in that game. We played well the night before, played well again that night, and felt like we deserved points out of those. So being able to get that result, get those two goals, and get it into overtime, and then obviously win it in the shootout, it was huge. And yeah, just the fans in that game, they drove us on that whole time. Like, once we scored that first one, they were backing us the whole way, and having a full building like that, it means the world to the players, and obviously we build off that momentum. So just having that is key, and hopefully we can continue to have that in the future.